Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Reproduction in Plants. In that, we are studying topic Microsporangium. We all have studied that there is a connective tissue present inside anther, and this connective tissue is nothing but Microsporangium, which we'll be studying today. Microsporangium is the connective tissue of the main gametophyte, or you can say the cell wall of the anther. Now, anther walls are made of this microsporangium. Microsporangium basically consists of three parts: the epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, and tape layer. The epidermis is the outermost layer and it provides protection. Endothecium is the internal layer or the second layer. Then comes the middle layer. The middle layer basically consists of 1 to 3 layers of parenchyma cells. And we all have studied what parenchyma cells are capable of doing. Parenchyma cells can eventually divide into different cell types. The last layer is tapetium. And tapetium helps in nourishment. It provides nourishment to the sporogenous tissue, which further take part in microsporogenesis. Structure of microsporangium. It consists of epidermis. Epidermis is basically the outermost protective part. It consists of endothecium, which is the internal layer, and endothecium provides the pathway, or it is a path for the pollen sacs. It consists of a single layer of cells. Middle layer. Middle layer, there are 1 to 3 parenchyma cells, and this parenchyma cells form internal to endothecium or endothecium structure. The last layer is tapetium or tapetum. Tapetium form the innermost wall surrounding, and this wall surrounding is basically around sporogenous cells, or you can say microsporangium. Now let's see what is the diagram of microsporangium. The diagram of microsporangium is somewhere like this. It consists of layers like epidermis, the outermost layer. Then the second most layer is endothecium or endothecium, whereas the middle layer is tapetium, and this tapetium provides nourishment to the sporogenous cells. Inside tapetium, as you can see, there are pollen grains present. So one can say that tapetium also provides protection, or you can say also provide nourishment to pollen grains, the male gametophyte. This together constitute the diagram of microsporangium. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied the structure of microsporangium, how microsporangium functions, and what are the different characteristics of microsporangium.
I hope you all are clear with the structure of microsporangium. Thank you.